Welcome to a series of videos designed to help you get the most out of Final Draft 12. In this tutorial, we're using a Mac, but we'll show you the Windows menus if they're different. Our focus is on getting started with Final Draft 12. In just a few minutes, you'll be able to turn this into this. A perfectly formatted script. The elements in screenplays, TV shows, and stage plays must be formatted to industry standards. To learn more about script formatting, visit finaldraft.com/learn for informative articles and video tutorials. When Final Draft launches and Choose Template is selected, you'll be asked to choose a template. Final Draft has templates for graphic novels, scripts, text documents, and TV shows, as well as educational templates. For this tutorial, we'll use Final Draft's industry standard screenplay template. When working in Final Draft, there are four main areas: the menu bar, the toolbar, the page, and the status bar. When working with a new file, first name and save the file. Go to the File menu, click Save As, type out the script file name, and save it to wherever you prefer. You might want to save it to your desktop for convenience. Now it's time to write some lines. The first line in most screenplays is called a scene heading. A scene heading describes where the scene takes place and the time of day. In the screenplay document, type the letter I. The Smart Type menu will appear and offer INT or I/E. INT, the abbreviation for interior, will be highlighted, accepted by pressing the Tab key. Type in a location such as home office and hit the Tab key again. The Time of Day Smart Type menu will appear and allow you to choose when the scene takes place. Choose night with the arrow key, the letter N on the keyboard, or with the mouse, and hit the Tab key again. The scene heading is automatically capitalized and formatted exactly to industry standards. After the scene heading, the next element you will type is called the action line. This describes the action or visual information that takes place in the scene. Confirm that you're in an action element by looking at the elements menu in the toolbar. Now type your first action sentence. Bob enters and sits down at the desk. Next, it's time to add some characters and dialogue lines. Hit return after the last action line to move to the next paragraph. This will bring up another action line, but a character name is next, so the elements need to be changed. Press return again to bring up the elements menu and choose character. You can also press the Tab key to shift from an action element to a character element. Now type a character name, such as Bob. Since dialogue usually follows a character element, it's only natural in this case to press return and write dialogue. Type alone at last. Hit the Tab key and insert a new parenthetical paragraph and type sees Kim. Note that the parentheses will be added automatically. Press return to continue Bob's dialogue and type, what are you doing here? Now press return twice to bring up the Smart Type menu of elements and choose character. Type Kim, then press return to move to Kim's line, which will be waiting for you. Now you can see how easy it is to add a few more lines each time using only the Tab or return key, as Final Draft will insert the next appropriate element when return or Tab is pressed. But what if there is a mistake? Just place the cursor in the line that needs correcting, choose the correct element from the Elements menu, and the mistake is fixed. The same goes for inserting new text. For example, we should describe Kim in the scene using an action line. Type, Kim sits on the edge of the filing cabinet in an evening gown, a gun in her hand. To add other kinds of paragraphs, such as shots like close on or transitions such as dissolve to, hold down the Command key on Mac or the Control key on Windows to display a row of paragraph types and numbers on the status bar. With the Control key held down, press the number of the paragraph type you want to insert and type in what you need. Kim should get a close-up here, and then we dissolve to the next scene. Now you know how to get a quick start in Final Draft 12. Thanks for watching. If you have any comments or suggestions, we want to hear them. Just go to Help, Submit Feedback, and let us know what you think. If you need technical support, go to Help, Get Support for access to Final Draft resources, including email, chat, and phone services. To watch more helpful video tutorials, visit the Final Draft YouTube channel at youtube.com/FinalDraftInc. Final Draft, the industry standard screenwriting software.